So this song, yeah, you feel like singing the song?
Lord goodness. You got the Bible turned me in Genesis. Chapter number 3. All that we've heard, we have experienced in this lifetime. We don't haven't experienced anything, you don't know anything. Isaiah ain't nothing been done. Amen. The Lord, He has blessed us to know these things, and this, and those are things that you don't have to reach for, those things that are given by the Spirit and inspiration of God. So He, when we are adopted into hope, then He already put something on the inside. Chapter 3, as it, you know how Genesis go, everybody reads Genesis, I hope they have. After God made man, Elder said that we're special. And He took His time with us. He didn't rush through it. A lot of people don't look at how man was made. Y'all can go ahead and say that, brother. As man was laying there, as the dew came, we made the water, and then as the ground was already there, He took that and He put it together. Yeah. And He molded man.
Amen.
Man had a form that he went by. A lot of people don't get this, but that was his soul. It was already there. He just molded to us to make man. But it just lay there, a soul and a body. Are y'all hear me? And there the body and the soul lay, but it had nothing that it could do. When God breathed breath into the man, the scripture said he became a living soul. He left that flesh out. Although it was there. Y'all hear him? After he breathed breath and man become a living soul, he wasn't no pride there. No pride going before the fall. So there wasn't no pride there. He just had an understanding that God is God. And on first hand relationship, born from the Spirit. Y'all hear that? Now we have to go from the flesh to the Spirit. But before we're from the Spirit to the flesh. So man humbled God from the beginning as he was born. And God stood him up there and he looked at him and he already done prepared the garden. A lot of folks don't get it. There was Eden, and then in Eden, God made a garden. He made a garden in Eden. And in the garden, then he prepared man, and in the garden he also, he took, I hear some of them preach sometimes that Adam woke up and found his wife. No, he didn't. God put a deep sleep on Adam. Went in and pulled out a rib. And if you read your Bible, the way I read it, looked like Adam got away. Then God formed the woman out of the rib and brought the woman to the man. So there ain't no need nobody trying to say that he tried to figure it out, because when he bought him to Adam, Adam said, bone of my bone. He wouldn't know that because God didn't tell him that. Amen? Bone of my bone. My flesh of my flesh. I call you woman. Ain't that right?
Amen.
We try to put too much on this, and with the scripture, it is profound by itself. We don't have to add to it. Just read what it says. You ain't got to guess it, because it says it if you take your time and read. And those who try to take other books and try to figure it out, the NIVs and all that, you ain't going to figure it out. Because it's given to them according to the Spirit.
That's right.
God good. According to who God has called. called. Yeah. He also did predestinate. He also called according to his own purpose.
That's right.
Ain't that what he said? Yeah, and because of that, everybody can't do it. I don't have to write out no message because God called the message in me. Amen. He also called the message in you. And every now and then, he didn't say for us not to study, show ourselves approved.
That's right.
But we have to get in his word.
Yeah.
And you can't get into something you don't know and ain't familiar with. So being born of God through Christ, then we become familiarized with the word. And the word was God. I'm getting ready to let it flow now. Well, in Genesis 3, after he had bought him in the garden, and he also he commanded him, he took him around. You know, brother, it's good to know that God, once he brings you to something, he'll show you around.
Yeah.
Want to do it?
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, before you even come into the fold, man, and in the church, we visit with our parents. But that ain't good enough because we'll go back out there and do what we want to do until a call comes.
That's right.
And when the call comes, then we find ourselves going over to the church house. And when we go to the church house, we don't know why we're going. We just feel like going. It ain't that. It's just something that's brought.
That's right.
Amen. Because according to the scripture said, the zeal of righteousness has always have been in God's people. Ain't that what it said? So the zeal is getting woke up. So while the zeal is being called for, then the part that God put in us is being awakened.
Amen.
And what has been awakened, then we come to the knowledge that we have a reason to be here. I don't know yet, but why I got a reason to be here. Somebody said, glad to have you, but you don't know. I'm just glad to be here. I don't know why. I'm just glad to be
there.
As God walked around in the garden, Adam was just glad to be there. And as he went around, he wanted to understand the stipulations to being here with me now. Y'all don't hear me, do you? As he walked around the garden, you can eat this tree. You can eat of this tree. You can eat of all this tree. But this tree you cannot eat. As he goes around with us, I'm here to tell y'all, as we come into the Lord, there are stipulations on your living and on your life. You just can't live like you want to. And then come to church on Sunday and say, oh, Father, I'm sorry, forgive me. That is not. Repentance. Yeah, that just says you're sorry for what you've done and you're going to do it again. Because repentance means to come away from. Ain't that all right? And as he walked around, he familiarized him with the garden. And he told him of this tree, you can eat this. And as he was going around, he said, of all these trees, when you get down into some of them, they got seeds, that's your meat. Ain't that all right? They tell you, he got to kill no animal, but your meat's already in the vine. We are created in the vine, we got the meat. And the meat, some, and in there, it's also milk. Come on now. In the coconut, you got the milk. And the coconut's in the tree. But there's milk, and then there's meat. Some can't eat the meat, so they have to eat the come from the coconut. That ain't God good. But as he told them, and Adam, he had an understanding. And by him having an understanding, it's just what was wrote in him. As he had the understanding, then the understanding, he didn't say God told me. Ain't that good? But I'm here to tell you that when God bring you to your wife, men, you ought to be husbands. And wives will be willing to listen if they come into the fold. Y'all know that's right. When God brought Eve unto Adam, he bought a good thing. Didn't it? Because Adam was by himself. God had the Father, he had the Son, and he had the Holy Ghost he was with. And he looked at that, he looked at the man that he made. He said it ain't good for him to be alone. So woman don't make the man do, but man has to do what he's supposed to do by showing the woman what to do. Don't you women get mad at me. I'm just giving you what the word is. Some people are afraid to do it to offend somebody, but I ain't that man. Because when it comes down to where the house not ruled by fist and by anger, but ruled by love and kindness with meekness and humbleness. When a man loves the woman that God brings to him, then there's something they got in common. And some people, they use this and they use that, but something that's in common is the most important thing. They both have Christ. If I love Christ and she loves Christ, we got the same love. Because we're acquainted with the same. chain, God.
Yes,
we're able to solve problems with that chain, God.
Yes,
right. And one is more, not more ruling than the other, but we have to come together. Yeah, and brethren, let us reason together. Ain't that what scripture says? Yeah, yeah. So war don't break out. Yeah, and you have something that will keep it down. Ain't God good?
Amen.
Yeah, but you got, I know how it is sometimes. It bothers me when I see women trying to tell men what to do, and it bothers me when men won't do what they're supposed to do. And that's why they said, I hope I don't offend nobody, that's why they all messed up saying that women have been called to preach, but I deny that because that ain't what my Bible says. Ain't God good? There's a place for the woman and there's a place for the man. And man was given the opportunity to walk with God and give the woman the law. And by not only giving the law, he had to demonstrate the law. And when he demonstrated the law, that he didn't even take time to walk. He may have walked past the tree of good and evil, but he didn't take time to talk to the rascal that was in. The woman, she come through. And a lot of them say she done it by herself. But I'm tell y'all something, the man walked up right to the tree with her. And she took conversation. And how do you know? Because he told the woman that you can eat of this tree. She said, no, we cannot eat of it. Y'all don't have to do it. You can't eat of this tree. Because this tree, I'll surely die if I partake of this tree. In other words, where the knowledge come from? She had a knowledge that was given unto her by her husband. And the husband received that knowledge by his God. Y'all can read it for yourself. If I had a servant, something happened to me. I ain't got to read it. That's my subject here tonight. Something happened to me. And Adam was just fine. And he was just fine. The woman ate of the fruit, and Adam was still just fine. But when she turned and gave the fruit to her husband, I'm going to tell you, women, something. If you want me, don't let your husband eat. Now, ain't got to read it. And if you eat it and he tell you not to, don't give it to him neither. Y'all don't hear me. Because it's not good to mess with something that God had done freed you from. And someone say, I won't hurt nothing. I hear him say sometime, I used to go on trips and I used to hear men and women talking about I'm saved and I joined the church and I love the Lord, and then you see them down back to the table and they're sitting up there with glasses of wine and drinking and laughing and hee-hawing. And I said, these are the same people that said they was talking about God. It ain't okay just because you ain't in the church. Church never leaves God's people. Because he put the church in our heart.
Yes, sir.
And when I'm here on 268, I'm Oleana at 163 L Street with the same church. My church has never left me since God put it in me. When he woke my church up one morning, and God arrived. He woke the church up in his people. And he woke the church up in Adam. And Adam understood what the church wanted. God had forbade him, and he meant just what he said. I'll tell y'all something, just because ain't nothing happened to you for your ill will, and don't mean nothing is going to happen to you. I'm here to tell you tonight, look on, because it is coming. You're going to then later on, it might be 10 years, and then somebody will say, I'm going to pray for you, but you know the truth. You might as well just lay on the word and say, Lord, I repent my sin. You see, some people take 10 years to repent their sin, and they shuffle the length of that sin.
That's right.
Because they have a hardened heart. Like old Pharaoh. But Adam took the fruit, and when he ate the fruit, he didn't look over and say, Eve, you feel different? He said immediately. Ain't nobody got to go to the altar to find out if it's on the inside. Church go with the heart begins shut and understanding begins and vaporize from out of memory and don't even begin to understand who you are after you have sinned against God. I know, because I done went down that road. Sinned against every man and woman have sinned against God. In God, all right. you know what it
is? Yeah.
The power of way to sin is dead, but the gift of God is eternal life. Every way and the sin aside, there shall be an easy answer. And run this race with patience.
Yes, sir.
That's the way it is.
Right.
We're going to have to learn how to obey God's word. And happy are you if you do whatsoever my Father has commanded you. When you do right, you feel good. And when someone stumbles on you, you still feel good. When the enemies turn it back on you and stab you in your back, you still feel good. And you wonder why do they say they love the Lord, always have a dagger sticking in my back. And every now and then you look up toward the hill where all your head comes from and say, Lord, I need your care.
Thank
God, all right. I know I'm a child of the King.
Thank you, Lord.
Time has proven itself in the Word of God. Every now and then, we ain't the only one going through something. Jesus went through everything.
Yeah.
And he took our sorrow. Come through this road, we fall down, but we keep getting up. John said, I saw a number that no man can number, falling down and getting up. Thank God, all right, coming up on the rough side of the mountain. All right, y'all, ain't God good? God knows them that will, and he knows them that won't.
Thank
God, all right, you don't have to claim it, it'll claim you. I'm so glad that one morning he called me with a home calling. According to my purpose, but according to his own purpose. And he's going to call me with a holy calling. Can you do it?
Yes,
he's calling you with a holy calling. How do you know that? Because something happened to me and I just couldn't explain. And I'm still this day, 40 years later, still trying to explain what happened to me. All I know, I got running in my feet. All I know, I got jaw down on me. Everybody's touching you. Somebody's touching me. They needed me. Somebody touched me. They needed my power. Virtue. Power of God. Virtue went out of
the Lamb.
God, all right. One morning, virtue went out of the Lamb.
Everybody
touch us. I'm going to tell you, I'm created. Christ Jesus. Come the good word that God had before our day. That we should walk in them. We now call according to our wounds and our condition. But we call according to his purpose and grace. Grace be the Son. If you ain't been born in the Lamb, you ain't been born yet. Jesus in me. Y'all hear what I said? Somebody say, I'm not like Jesus. I want to tell you one thing. One more. In 1973, I found out something happened to me early in the morning. Something happened to me. Opened up my eyes where I could see. Had ears and heard the bell desire. I could hear angels singing in the room, and I got so happy I couldn't even sleep. But when it happened, I knew something was different. I just couldn't wait to tell somebody. I just couldn't wait to tell somebody. The only one that been born to get in the house. I just waited and waited, but before that, the Lord had already dealt with me. If I had up all the time that I realized, now that he was bothering my old man, shutting him down. I was a young boy, and he was shutting him down before he could get of age. Don't tell nobody that God can't change a child. But I'm here to tell you, he changed this child. And I never went back out China. I may want to desire because I've seen others do it. But God put wolves on me.
He
put parrots on my feet.
Yeah.
He had a bridle in my tongue.
Yeah.
And he pulled the rein of time.
Yeah.
He said, you can't go, you belong to me.
Yes, sir.
But you my child, you're a royal priesthood.
All right.
Yeah, Lord. glory. One is created in my Son. Well, I was saved, I was chained one morning, and I was without sin. Y'all hear that? That morning when he ripped all the sin off of me, I hadn't even been old enough to produce it, but I produced just enough for God to take it off and make me a pure soul before him. And we are created through Christ, rinsed through the blood, water, grace, come down the same water that the woman got at the well. Let me tell y'all about somebody. It'll be able to have free grace. Free grace. Jesus Christ ain't that the way it is. He said, I have the gift of grace. Nobody don't even know what the gift of grace is. It was Jesus' Son. It was God's Son, Jesus, put before us that we may be cleansed from all unrighteousness. Take out the old man. Old man go to sleep. New man walk forth. But trust in the Lord.
Yes, right.
For he will keep you through everything. God knows everything we go through. What bothers me about people? It ain't the world that's the problem, it's the people.
Right.
That's the problem.
That's right.
When God changed us, don't live on the edge of life.
Yeah.
Keep saying, well, ain't nobody perfect.
Yeah.
I was.
Yeah.
But I changed it myself.
That's right.
Yeah. And then I began to ask God, what happened?
Yeah.
I know what happened.
Sin.
When he took me in his word, he showed me I sinned against grace.
Yeah.
I sinned against his Son. His Son didn't die for nothing.
Right.
His Son died and made me whole.
Right.
His Son died to give me a home.
Yeah.
He said, I'll go away to a prepared place for you, and if I go,
I'll come get
it. And he said, not only will I come, I'll receive
you
unto myself. Don't get in and say, if you sin, just go to heaven. That ain't going to happen. I don't care if we predestinated or not. You ain't going to see him get in heaven. You got to get rid of that mess. Come on. Amen. I'll tell y'all something. When you met me this morning, I got them clothes I got on this morning. Amen. And God went home and I changed. I'll just let that sit with you just for a minute. Y'all got it, right? When we make changes, you can't keep putting clothes on that thing because I'm off. Y'all hear me?
Yeah,
I hear you. You just can't keep putting clothes on when I take some off.
That's right.
So when he took off what you couldn't match. Come on, man. I said, when we come, when God, listen, you didn't go to Christ on your own.
No.
God threw that hook in you.
Yeah.
At a certain time in your life, he took that rod and reel. Y'all know how I do it this way. And he started reeling.
Come on.
70, he started reading.
Yeah.
71, he kept on reading. 72, he kept on reading. I was fighting like a fish in the water. And 73, I give up. I quit fighting. And he caught me through the net. The net of grace. Come on. There's still a little fight. Because I desired where I was. And didn't know why I wanted to be there. And some of you are older and had experienced the world. I wasn't like y'all, man. I'm saying that because I don't know how old many of y'all, but some of you are old.
Yeah.
Hearing somebody's story, when he caught you at a, it wasn't late, it was just right.
That's right.
Because he knew what it was going to take. Some of you have to go through something to learn something.
There you go.
I I don't understand how anyone can be in Christ and then be out of it. No, I don't get that.
Yeah.
I'm not my keeper.
No.
I have to fight him hard to get away from him.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to say that. But I don't tell you how I know that. I tried to leave church. I told one of them this morning. I tried to leave church four times to quit going. Because I done got disgusted with the people who claim Christ.
Yeah.
But every time I left, it's just like he done this. I couldn't see.
Yeah.
If it's right. Where I couldn't make it away,
yeah.
And I couldn't find the next day, I just knew I was back in the house.
No life, right?
And I want to tell you something. I'm glad that he kept me blind too soon. Because I wanted to sin against him. And I want to tell you something. I fought with God. He made me angry.
Yeah.
Look at y'all, look at him. Oh yeah, he made me angry because everything was in his power. Well, that's, I knew everything was in God's power. I asked him for one thing.
That's right.
I said, I've served you all the time. I just asked you for one thing. You didn't do it for me, so I ain't doing nothing else for you.
That's right.
That didn't work.
Yeah.
You see where I'm at, though.
That's right.
I tried to get out of my car to commit sin, and the doors wouldn't, they wouldn't lock, but they wouldn't open.
Oh, yeah.
Tried to roll the windows down to get out. I was determined. And they wouldn't wind down. I don't care if you believe it or not. I know what God did. And you know why I talk about it now? It's because I'll tell you what grace can do.
Yeah.
If you love him, and he know I love you.
Yeah,
but my feelings in the flesh was hurt.
Sure, you go.
Now, you hear what I said? Your feelings in the flesh don't mean nothing to God. He can treat that. And if you're weak-minded, you go to the doctor, he can treat it. But if you keep going spending your money like the woman who spent all of her, then it do you no good if you know it's God. Amen. Then you try to figure out, I don't have to ask you more what happened. Grace happened.
Glory. Well done, brother.
Darryl.